In this particular mini video session, we are going to solve the assignment problem of decision making. The problem states, given the marks of 5 subjects, calculate the total, find the percentage, and then print out the grade of that candidate. So let us assume that the marks are out of 100 for each subject. So the total marks are not going to be more than 500. So if the percent is between 0 to 39, I'm going to say fail. If the percent is between 40 to 50, I'm going to say pass class. If it is between 51 to 60, I'm going to say second class. If it is between 61 to 70, I'm going to say first class. And anything above 71 to 100, I'm going to say distinction. You need to understand a few things here. Even if it is 39.9998, it will still be fail. It has to be completely 40. So this is the first assumption we are making. Now what I am doing is, in order to store the marks of the 5 subjects, I have to reserve 5 memory locations and I give them the names M1, M2, M3, M4 and M5. These are the names of 5 variables. Then the sum of M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 plus M5 is going to hold in a variable called as total, and percentage is used to calculate the percent based on the total. The only data I need is I need to read the marks of the 5 subjects from the user. In the next step, what I am going to do here is, once I read the marks, I am going to calculate the total. So total is the sum of all the marks. Now for 500, a student has got so many marks. For 100, he has got how much? So percentage is total into 100 upon 500. So it will give you the percentage. Once you calculate the percentage, then what you're going to do next is, you're going to ask the question, is the percent less than or equal to 39? In this case, you will print, sorry, fail. Other possibilities are, there are still 4 more possibilities. So I'm going to use the else if condition. So else if the percent is greater than or equal to 40 and less than or equal to 50, then I'm going to print pass class. Then 51 to 60, then again I'll have to use a else if. Else if the percent is greater than or equal to 51 and less than or equal to 60, then print second class. Now we come to 61 to 70. Else if percent is greater than or equal to 61 and less than or equal to 70, then we are going to print first class. And finally, if he is not in any of these categories, we are going to straight away say print congratulations, distinction, and then stop. Now, simple way, as usual, let's evaluate doing a test run. So what I have done is, I have given the marks of 5 subjects here, 80, 90, 80, 95, 100. Most likely this is going to be a distinction candidate because of the kind of marks. So in step number 2, I have read all these marks. Step number 3, total is going to come as 445. And in the next step, I am going to calculate the percentage. Percentage here is coming as 89% for all these 5 subjects. Once I know it's 89%, then it is quite a simple task. So what I am going to do here is, now I am going to use this percent to compare. Is 89 less than 39? It is false. Is percent between 40 and 50? It is also false. Is percent between 61 and 70? That is also false. And if you look at percent, percent is 89. It is between greater than 70. So I'll just print congratulations, distinction, and stop. Just one important thing to learn, just to, so that you don't forget it. If this condition is true, the program will not go to any of this. It will directly come and stop. That means if somebody has got, say, 35%, it will print sorry, fail, and stop. So in the if, else if, else if, else, only the condition which is true will get executed. If none of the conditions are true, then automatically, assuming there is a else, the else will get executed and you will halt. So I hope this clarifies your understanding of one more programming logic assignment using algorithm.